Namaskar and good afternoon to everyone. Honorable Minister of Education Pokhriyal sir, Professor DP Singh, UGC Chairman, Professor Kasturi Rangan and his team, congratulations to everyone who is here. Professor Kasturi Rangan sir, I just want to share with you that I am just overwhelmed with your speech. The way the ideas have flown from your thoughts into your words, they were so convincing and they were so appealing. So congratulations to you, sir. In fact, referring to Gandhiji's words, you know, he spoke about Nai Taleem. और वो जो नई तालीम की बात कर रहे थे उस जमाने में तो ही फाउंड दैट देयर वाज ए डिस्कनेक्ट बिटवीन माइंड बॉडी एंड सोल एंड दिस कुड बी एड्रेस्ड ओनली बाय द एजुकेशनिस्ट एंड द एजुकेशन सिस्टम ऑफ द कंट्री. द एनईपी हैज एम्बेडेड दिस इनटू इट्स डिजाइन एंड द न्यू एजुकेशन सिस्टम विल डेवलप अ पीपल एट द मेंटल, फिजिकल, स्पिरिचुअल, एस्थेटिक एंड इंटेलेक्चुअल लेवल. दैट आई एम वेरी श्योर अबाउट. The policy is focused also on early childhood care and education. When we say early childhood care, that itself shows that how carefully we have and how mindfully we have designed the education for the children, which is 5+3+3+4 model. We are very mindfully done, and researchers have also shown that the children's personality, their behavior, their character is all developed at those early stages, formative years, where we are actually not educating and parenting the children the way they should have been. So this is going to go a long way in giving us very healthy citizens for the country. Introducing vocational education from the middle stages at the school level is yet another commendable recommendation, where the students are going to go for bagless internships, sitting with the instructors and the craft, the people who are actually the craft persons, the traders, the artists, and people who are actually working in the field. And when we begin all this at the school level, this also helps us in higher education system to have a continuity from the school vocational education system to the university vocational education system, and we can plan our own curriculum and design our own curriculum in a more scientific and planned manner, so that our students can get the vocations of their choices. They can prepare their life for the occupation, their jobs, their career, and finally their professions in life. We are all going to be shifting to the more liberal education system in the country. Since I am the Vice Chancellor of the Social Science and Humanities University, I see a lot of scope for my university to play the leadership role in terms of offering the social sciences input to technology institutions and management institutions, and also to industry per se. So I am very excited about this policy, where we'll have a bigger role to play. The kind of academic and administrative autonomy we have been referring to in the policy document all the time, and Professor Kasturi Rangan has been saying it time and again, sir, the real empowerment and real implementation will lie in the perfect economy, perfect autonomy, which is going to be given to the vice chancellors and the head of the institutions, both academically and financially. I think that will make hell of a difference. The renewed and re-energized focus on research in the national education policy will also help our universities to appear in the international rankings, and also give credibility and recognition to our research and our publication. I'm very sure we are going in the right direction in that sense. Doing away with affiliation and affiliated colleges concept is a very welcome step, and universities would be less pressurized on the UG programs, which we feel that university system should actually be focusing more on masters and research, and that will make far more sense to us. In fact, looking at the multidisciplinary educational research universities which have been proposed at Meru's, we are very excited to understand the kind of model this public university is going to have, and we would definitely would want to participate in whatever form we can in such model universities. Internationalization has got special focus. And internationalization and the top 100 universities which we are going to be welcoming in India. I think in morning session there were some speakers who even spoke about India's participation in other countries in term, in higher education. I think that should also be looked into. So we are all very, very excited about this policy. We know that when something new and a change comes in, change brings a lot of anxiety and pressure. We do have little anxiety about its implementation, but we are all the soldiers and the warriors who are ready to implement it all in the spirit in which it has been crafted and drafted. My best wishes to the team once again.